basement said, just walk this way to the dawn of the light. Wind will blow into your face as the years pass you by. Hear this voice from deep inside. It's the call of your heart. Close your eyes and you will find passage out of the dark. Here I am. Will you send me an angel?
Like the court orders don't mean nothing. They keep telling you to go back to court. You spend thousands of dollars on courts where that money should actually go to the children instead of those lawyers or the judges who will buy another house up at Whistler or another Mercedes.
Parents that thought, you know, I mean, well, I believed at the end of it, you know, I mean, we were the adults in the situation that I would go on my separate way, she would go on her separate way.
According to Ed Hoyt, but we still have a way to go. Boyd has been through the court system himself and now plays a role in changing a system that hasn't changed much since the 1960s, and he's doing that in the province of
Maine. Four times went back to the system, and judges saying, no, sir, right there, you have a custody order here in place. And it just astounded me, the amount of times when I was in there that nothing was ever done. I realized over taking a look at the different situations that people, when you become a non-custodial parent, even male or female even today, you no longer have the right to be a parent, that you're forced to fight. And it's amazing. I mean, people don't realize what type of damage they're doing to their children. They're actually showing their children that the custodial parent is actually above the law, that the piece of paper that a justice has written isn't worth the piece of paper it's written on.
Well, yet?
Right now, and I'm going off the Canadian statistics, 70% of women are awarded either sole custody or joint custody with primary residence. Primary residence, and there's no difference. And that's the reason why we've gone to the equal parenting model. Denmark, Australia, Germany, countries that have been progressive in this have lowered their divorce rates. Children are not, the crime rate has dropped. So, for people to take a look at what it will create compared to the old system, fathers in this country are being discriminated against. You know what I mean? I'd be relying on the people of the country saying that, no, fathers aren't discriminated against. They are. It's sad. But non-custodial women that are having the same thing starting to happen to them, not to the same extreme that fathers have had over the last
nearly as often, but it does happen.